Hey everybody, welcome to another Photoshop CS6 tutorial. I'm your host, Buddy Blackford, and today I'm going to go over the minimum requirements for your computer to be able to run Photoshop CS6, and I'm going to add in my input of what I think you should really have to run CS6. So, since CS6 can be ran on Windows and Mac systems, I'm going to post up both of them so you know what to have or what you need to upgrade on your computers. So I use a PC, and I'm going to be more knowledgeable about using the Windows platform than I am the Mac, but I do know I have used Macs before several times, just never actually have been able to build a Mac, since I usually just buy them from the store and they're already built. I guess I like to build my own computers and Windows or PCs, so I've got a little bit of an advantage when I'm talking about Windows over Mac. Anyways, I'm not gonna get into Windows versus Mac debates, but we'll leave that for you guys to decide in the forums. So for Windows, we're gonna have a couple processors that are our minimum requirements here. And you're going to need a Intel Xeon, Centrino, or Pentium 4. And these are the minimum requirements. Anything that's been created later than these, you can also use. And it's recommended any of these will be fine to run Photoshop CS6. For the Mac, it's the Intel-based Mac processors. For your operating system, the lowest for Windows is Vista. And I would recommend getting something like either Windows 7 or Windows 8, which can handle more memory for being able to use the Photoshop CS6 64-bit, which I'll talk about next in the next tutorial. For the Mac, you need the OS X 10.6.6. For both systems, you're going to need 1 GB available on your hard drive. Of course, you're going to want to have way more than that available because your pictures and then your Photoshop files and everything like that. But this is what you need to be able to install it on your system. My recommendation is to get another hard drive, either an external hard drive or another hard drive, internal hard drive that you use just to store stuff on as a backup, in case some of your files get corrupted or your hard drive gets corrupted somehow, you'll have a backup. The worst thing is to have worked on a bunch of programs, made a bunch of cool stuff, and your hard drive fails, and then you lose everything. Now you have nothing to put show on your demo reels or show in your portfolio or anything like that to other people that might want to hire you or use you as a Photoshop expert. For RAM, which is memory, you're going to need for both 1 GB of RAM minimum. Now, 2 GB is recommended by Adobe for using Photoshop. I would recommend having at least 4 to 8 GB of RAM, because when you start using Photoshop, if you can use Photoshop CS6 64-bit, higher RAM will give you better performance. Now for a video card, you can have both of these 16-bit 256 MB video cards. I would recommend having at least a 1 GB video card. 256 is probably going to be a little slow, so get a 1 GB video card. Anything that's been made in the past 2 years will probably be good. For your monitor, same thing for both. 1024x768 is the resolution that you're going to want. Now, in my opinion, if you're going to be using Photoshop a lot and you plan on making a living out of it, I would get the best monitor that you could afford. It should be an HD monitor with a 1080p resolution at least, and it should be able to handle lots of colors. So an LED monitor would be nice, but get the best one that you can, because the whole thing about Photoshop is working with a lot of colors to make sure that what you're working on looks good on not just your monitor, but like everywhere else. So if your colors are all effed up on your monitor, then they're going to be effed up everywhere else, and you're going to be like, oh crap, I didn't realize that it looks so crappy. So make sure that you get a pretty good monitor, the best that you can afford. So those are just the requirements that you need, the minimum requirements, and then I give you my my recommendations myself. I guess that's it. I always have a hard time ending all these tutorial videos. Not really sure how to end them in like a way that sounds cool, but I'd just like to thank you guys for watching and subscribe to keep updated on all the Photoshop tutorials that are going to be coming out soon. So I'm going to be making a bunch of them, and I'd like to thank you guys for watching them. So see you guys later. Have a good one.